Welcome back to The Wire. It's 20 minutes past two, and Helena is in the studio for the Revelation film review.
Hello. Nice to be here.
How's it going?
Good.
Now, what film did you see over the weekend?
I saw Liebestraume, which is it's a documentary drama about Killer Ray. Liebestraume, I think, translates to the absurd dreams. And absurd it was.
Was it? Mm. In what way?
Well, it's based on this character called Killer Ray, who surely you must have come across Killer Ray.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? So most people in Auckland have. He doesn't live here anymore. He lives in Bangkok now, because what happened, part of being thanked for doing the film, they gave him a ticket to Bangkok and he never came back, which is quite funny. He says it's the ideal place for him, full of sunshine.
What was he known for?
He was a musician. I think he started off with his first gig at the Old Squid, and he'd sit with a keyboard and sort of hum along to old tunes and wear a mask and odd outfits and stuff. And this guy, Florian, who went to Elam, started making a short film about him and then turned it into a feature, which is quite unique in itself. Feature-length documentary in New Zealand is quite hard to get out, especially with very little funding, as he had. And so it was shown at the film festival. Might be coming back if it gets moved to 35mm and is popular enough, but I'll quickly tell you what it's about. Florian's got all these actors to reenact different parts of his life, which is funny. He starts off as a shy paper boy and then moves up into being this older man. He's always had this obsession with scrubbing his chest with toothbrushes in the shower, which is
sore, to say the least.
Sore, but also bizarre, as he is and as he was. I think he was diagnosed as being insane. Lunacy. He was diagnosed with lunacy by his nurse, who then seduced him. Oh, maybe he made that up. Anyway, odd, fascinating movie. It's got a definite David Lynch feel. There are sort of slow, quiet bits with music and odd characters who are quite sexual. But it works. Definitely works.
How long does it go for?
I think it's an hour and 20 minutes, roundabout there.
So it's not too long to sit through?
Not too long. It's a good length. And it has lots of little sort of artistic pieces intertwined. So it's not just a documentary, it's like a drama as well.
Mm. And there is a soundtrack to go with it as well.
You're right.
We've been playing a little bit.
Oh, have you? Yeah, I hear that the soundtrack was all made especially for the movie and composed, which is really cool. It's really cool music.
Mm.
Yeah. And all done by New Zealanders voluntarily and on a very small budget.
Oh, good on them.
It was in part funded. But there are some great techniques in it. You've got characters speaking without their lips moving. I don't know how to describe it, but you see them in bed just looking at each other. It's not a still, but it's moving film. And then you have voiceovers over the top, and it's almost their thoughts.
Wow.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
So it's kind of a dreamy sort of sense as well.
It is.
If it's by memory, it must be.
Yeah, it is kind of a dreamy sense. Well put. Well put, Renee.
Hmm. Would you see it again?
I would see it again. I'd recommend people see it. A couple of people said to me they thought it lacked a bit of structure, but I mean, I don't think it necessarily needed structure.
Films by memory often do, though, don't they? Because you sort of skip.
Yeah.
They're quite fragmented.
Maybe the people who said that just weren't understanding it.
Maybe they weren't.
And a couple of the characters were a bit difficult to work out who they were at the beginning, but you get the feel of it. I was fascinated the entire way through, riveted by the bizarre oddness that was Liebestraume.
Fantastic. Thanks, Helena, for reviewing that.
That's
I'm sure it wasn't too much trouble at all. Okay. 1:45, Stephen Gray's up very shortly with...